There are certain plants that always capture people's imagination because they're beautiful, unusual, and in some cases, lethal. I'm escaping a sudden downpour and heading into a beautiful glasshouse full of carnivores. Some carnivorous plants, like the Venus flytrap, actively trap their prey. But most of the plants in this house use passive traps. Nepenthes and Sarracenia are also known as pitcher plants because they have large modified leaves in the shape of a jug or pitcher, which they use to capture and digest insects and the occasional mammal.
They use their attractive colors to attract insect or prey because sometimes it's like a rotten meat. And then they also emit a distinctive fragrance from their nectar glands, also to attract insects to their traps.
Michael Yudhistira is the manager of horticulture across all four of Indonesia's botanic gardens. He's been obsessed with carnivorous plants since he was a little boy. So this newly built display is one of his favorite projects.
So what drew you to the pitcher plant?
The first thing, I spent my childhood always alone in my house since both of my parents are working. But they always provide me with a lot of encyclopedia about flora and fauna. Mm-hmm. And during my childhood, I read a lot about these carnivorous plants. Since then, my passion for them grows very drastically. And the more I go, the more I love them. They are very interesting plants.
Indonesia is a Nepenthes hotspot, with more species found here than anywhere else in the world.
What is the size range of the pitchers?
The smallest one is below 5 centimeters, but one of the largest can be exceeding 40 centimeters, like Nepenthes truncata or Raja. Sometimes they also trap small rodents like squirrel or rats. After 2 or 3 weeks, usually only their hair and bones left inside the pitchers, and it's very stinky.
Wow, that's terrifying. Ooh, this one looks sinister.
This one is famous as the Draculas of Nepenthes because it has 2 fangs that produce specialized nectar, and they also have a abusive relationship with a specific ants.
Wow.
But sometimes it's also a symbiosis because, as you can see, the tendril is very thick, mm-hmm. so some of the ants make a shelter inside the tendrils. So the ants are very attracted to the nectar in the fangs. The ants usually climb the pitchers using these wings as a ladder, and they go into the fangs, and they fall into the pitchers. So it's kind of a very complicated relationship, right?
Oh, yeah.
Mas Yudis, ini kan nepenya udah beberapa udah ada yang banyak tinggi. Apa perlu kita lakukan propagasi? Ya?
Boleh sih, apalagi yang kayak ini, itu sama ini. Ini lumayan sih nanti di cutting.
Michael and his team are on an urgent mission to help people better understand and appreciate these fascinating plants. New species are still being discovered in remote places, but many more are threatened as their habitat shrinks.
What a beautiful curation of rare and important species here. What is your long-term goal for having a display like this?
Of course, our long-term goal is to increase awareness and curiosity for the people and kids. And since a lot of them are already rare or threatened, we are planning to reintroduce them back in the wild.
Awesome.